Donkey of the Day.
Donkeys of the Day, ask Charlemagne.
I'm a Democrat, so being Donkey of the Day is a little bit of a mixed blessing.
So like a donkey.
Yee-haw.
Okay. Donkey of the Day.
The Breakfast Club, bitches.
Now, I've been called a lot in my 23 years, but Donkey of the Day is a new one.
Yes, Donkey of the Day for Friday, May 19th goes to sports journalist Jason Lee Whitlock. If you don't know who Jason Whitlock is, he is the co-host of a daily sports TV show that I never heard of until yesterday called Speak for Yourself on Fox Sports 1. Now, Fox Sports 1 has been in the news this week because Colin Cowherd had LeVar Ball on his show this week, and LeVar got into an exchange with Kristen Leahy, also of Fox Sports 1. Play that real quick to refresh everyone's memory.
Have you sold any shoes yet?
Yeah, I sold a good amount to me. Like I said, there's different amounts.
How many?
Stay in your lane. Anyways, calling her, like I was telling you, man.
I'm just curious.
I don't even worry about her over there.
Every
time she scares me to death, I'm thinking of Saul right now. Hey, my problem is you are a hater.
Okay, now I gave Kristen Leahy Donkey of the Day this week for those comments, because that is textbook, let me weaponize my whiteness to demonize the black man. Anybody who can't see that doesn't want to see it. And I said during Donkey of the Day that she played the race card by accident. I don't even know if she weaponized her whiteness on purpose, but that's what she did, and I stand by my statement. That's the same kind of energy that got Emmett Till killed. You got these idiots who want to say, how can you compare LeVar Ball to Emmett Till? I'm not comparing LeVar Ball to Emmett Till. I'm simply saying the same weaponizing of whiteness to demonize the black man is what got Emmett Till killed. That's the same energy Christine Leahy gave out in the middle of that exchange. Yes, that man says, you're going to get what's coming to you, Christine Leahy. That's him simply saying karma is going to come your way based off the comments you've made about him and how he raised his kids. But Christine, by your logic, if you think that's a threat, then Jason Whitlock definitely threatened me yesterday on Colin Cowherd's show to Herd. Can we play that?
Charlemagne the God has come at Christine in a totally unprofessional, dangerous, irresponsible way. Some of this is spun in a racial way that I think is difficult for white people to handle. This is my area of expertise. I'm going to go at Charlemagne the God and all these idiots. Charlemagne the God and the Breakfast Club is the most powerful, popular, urban radio show in America.
In New York, L.A. based?
New York, but it's a national show. It's Sirius XM. He needs to be dealt with, and he's going to get dealt with.
We're not Sirius XM, we're iHeart, damn it. I'm going to be dealt with. I need to be dealt with. That is a threat, Jason Whitlock. If you think what LeVar Ball said to your precious Christine Leahy is a threat, then you saying you're going to deal with me is absolutely a threat. Jason Whitlock said that I am spinning this in a racial way that is hard for white people to handle. You know why it's hard for white people to handle? Because waste of good black skin like you, Jason Whitlock, get around these Caucasians in corporate settings and don't tell the truth. How are we going to make racial progress in this country if we don't communicate? Tell them the truth. Same way Christine Leahy can say what makes her uncomfortable, I can point out as a black man what makes me uncomfortable. And Kristen Leahy demonizing LeVar Ball and weaponizing her whiteness by saying this man was threatening her when he clearly wasn't makes me uncomfortable. And yes, I use the example of Emmett Till because that's the same kind of energy that got him killed. News like that wouldn't be hard for white people to handle, Jason Whitlock, if Negroes in position like you to tell them the truth told them the truth. But you too busy attacking black people and demonizing us that you don't seem to understand that. Malcolm X once said, if you're not careful, the newspapers will have you hating the people who are being oppressed and loving the people who are doing the oppressing. Well, it's 2017. If Malcolm was alive, he wouldn't say newspaper. He would say media, and he would be talking directly to Negroes like you. Because when Jason Whitlock got on his show, Speak for Yourself, yesterday, along with Eric Davis, Chris Broussard, and the damsel in distress, Kristen Leahy, he said
the most powerful, Charlemagne the God, did a commentary labeling you the donkey of the day. And this kind of sent me over the top because he went as far as to analogize this to what happened with Emmett Till. For Charlemagne the God to use his platform, the most powerful urban hip-hop station in America with a huge following, to throw that kind of heat on you when your intentions weren't malicious at all, your interaction with LeVar Ball wasn't disrespectful at all. For him to throw that kind of heat on you and your family, this is ridiculous. And it plays into a racial politics that has gotten out of hand or via social media. Charlemagne, stop it. Cut it out. Grow up. Be a man. You don't need that to build your following. Social media, people over Twitter, please stop and think. We're being racially divided for no reason, for the entertainment of people over Twitter and Instagram. This needs to stop.
This was never supposed to be a war, and it's turned into it. It was never supposed to be a war between me and LeVar, between me and Charlemagne the God, and now it's turned into that. It's not a war on race. It's not a racial discussion. It's not a feminist discussion. It was about respect. And to Charlemagne the God, I would love to go on your show. I've actually been a fan of The Breakfast Club. And if we can have a healthy conversation about this and make some good come out of it, let's do it. Put some respect on my name.
Now, Jason Whitlock has the nerve, the unmitigated gall, to say what I said was irresponsible, inappropriate, dangerous, out of bounds. Even had the nerve to say that I don't have to demonize someone. But not once did you check Christine Leahy for demonizing LeVar Ball. Not once did you tell Christine Leahy that her demonization of LeVar Ball is dangerous. And Eric Davis and Chris Broussard, I'm disappointed in you both, because not once did either one of you Negroes speak up and try to explain to the damsel in distress why she was in the wrong. Even if you feel like LeVar Ball was in the wrong, do you think her playing the victim and positioning herself like she was in some sort of danger from the big scary black man was okay? Y'all keep screaming about lack of respect for Christine Leahy, but on that show to her, she's positioned in the back of the bus. You want people to look her in the eyes and talk to her. How? What guest has eyes in the back of their head? If you respect her so much, position her to where she's a real part of the show, and guests don't have to break their neck to talk to her. Hey, Christine, last thing I have to say to you is, the way they have you positioned in that room is how they feel you should be positioned in life. Okay, behind the guys, way off to the side. But F that, it's not about you right now, it's about Jason Whitlock. Jason Whitlock, you have the nerve to talk about someone being inappropriate, irresponsible, dangerous, out of bounds. Jason Whitlock, have you met yourself? Okay, I remember an article you wrote about Serena Williams calling her an underachiever. Serena Williams, the greatest tennis player of all time, top five athletes of all time, regardless of gender. You said she was an underachiever. One of your lines from that article was, seriously, how else can Serena fill out her size 16 shorts without grazing at her stall between matches? Jason Whitlock said Serena Williams has chosen to smother her athletic gifts into an unsightly layer of thick muscular blubber, a byproduct of her unwillingness to commit to a training regimen and diet. All of this coming from a man who waddles when he walks, a man who looks like he has to concentrate with every breath he takes, has the nerve to body shame Serena Williams. But that's what you do, Jason Whitlock. You love tearing down black excellence. You always strive to demonize black people in the media for absolutely no reason. Let's run through a few of them, shall we? I just told you about Serena. Well, Jason Whitlock also had something negative to say about LeBron James' equality commercial. How you speak down about a man who did a commercial encouraging equality? Listen to what he said about LeBron.
My point about LeBron James that I don't think people are getting, his athletic privilege and wealth define him more than the poverty and or racism that he experienced growing up. And therefore, if you buy that, you'll understand my analogy of why I say he's no different than Donald Trump.
My Emmett Till analogy is crazy, but wow. LeBron is like Donald Trump.
Come on, now that's crazy.
How, Sway? LeBron is about building bridges, bringing people together. Donald Trump builds walls. He wants to keep people divided. How are they remotely the same? Jason Whitlock also doesn't think Colin Kaepernick is authentic. Let's hear it.
Should Cap's sincerity still be questioned?
100%, and I think it's fair game. This kid was about Instagram models, tattoos, his abs, and building up the Colin Kaepernick brand until the very moment he loses his starting quarterback job. And now he's out here and he's Martin Luther Cornroll. I don't buy it. I don't care. Oh, he's raising awareness for this or that.
See, that rhetoric is dangerous because it makes it seem like the issue that Colin Kaepernick was protesting isn't important. If you're making the white people you work with feel like Colin Kaepernick's protests aren't important, then by default, you're making what Colin Kaepernick is actually protesting, which is the unarmed killing of people, especially people of color, by the police, seem not important. But Jason Whitlock, this is what you do. It's your stick. This is how you get attention. Attack and demonize folks that are black and prominent in our community. I refuse to believe you would come caping for a woman of color the way you caping for Christine Leahy. See, you keep telling me not to make this a race thing, but the same way Christine Leahy used a textbook example of weaponizing whiteness and demonizing blackness, you are a textbook example of a twisted house slave. You are Steven in the Django. You are doing what you have to do to keep your white counterparts happy because you think it gives you some sort of job security. I mean, look, it's documented that no black people at ESPN wanted to work with you, so you went over to Fox Sports 1 to be the white man's watchdog. That's all you do is balk and try to bite black people on behalf of the white man. Because if that wasn't your agenda, you would have at least attempted to school Christine Leahy on why her rhetoric was dangerous, not just to LeVar Ball, but historically. Why that type of energy has been dangerous to black men in this country forever. Now, Jason Whitlock, I know you threatened me, and said I was going to be dealt with, but I need you to have that same enthusiasm when it comes to dealing with your obesity. Okay, you need to lose weight, my brother. All right, your first, last, and best love will always be self-love, and that's why you don't love anyone. Look, Jason Whitlock is a house slave, but he don't love the white man. All he does is tear down black people, so we know he doesn't love us. But truth is, Jason Whitlock doesn't love himself. If he loved himself, he would lose weight. Hurt people hurt people. And when you are built like Cleveland Brown from Family Guy in real life, 9 times out of 10, you're hurt. And you better not get on Fox Sports 1 today and say I body shamed you, because damn it, you body shamed Serena. Mm-mm. And I'm not going back and forth with you, because I know you eat this kind of attention up. I mean, you eat everything up, but you really love dining on attention. And I'm not giving you any more until you lose 200 pounds. I refuse to go back and forth with a man who doesn't love himself, okay? I would not take any critique from you serious until you take your life serious and lose weight. Jason Whitlock, if you're confused on what I'm telling you, it's simple. You're too fat for a fedora. And I don't take fat house slaves and fedoras seriously. I'm just using this as a moment to teach the white people you work with that are confused about why the Christian Leahy situation with LaVar Ball is so serious. And it's simply because some white women in this country have a history of weaponizing their whiteness to demonize the black man. And if guys like Jason Whitlock can't convey that message, then guys like Charlamagne the God can. Please give the fat fedora wearing house slave Jason Whitlock the biggest hee-haw, please.
All right.
I told y'all I was spreading love today.
That's a lot of love.
I'm giving out love for free this
morning. You had that same energy. I like that.
I'm giving out love for free.
I like that. The Breakfast Club.